So, you've been to see your doctor and you've had a progesterone blood test done to find out if you're ovulating or not, and perhaps to also see if your progesterone levels are high enough for getting pregnant. And now you've got your results back and you're wondering what they mean. Is your progesterone too low? Is it too high? And what does it mean for your chances of getting pregnant? If you want to find out what your progesterone levels mean for both ovulation and getting pregnant, then stick with me for the next few minutes to find out. Hi, I'm Juliette Miller. I'm a trained natural fertility specialist with over 20 years' experience. And welcome to Focus on Fertility, the YouTube channel dedicated to supporting you on your fertility journey with science-based tips and information you can trust to help you get pregnant as soon as possible. Okay, before we jump in, let's do a quick progesterone 101. Why is progesterone so important, and why would you get your levels of this hormone tested? Progesterone is one of the key female reproductive hormones. It's a wonderful hormone that does a number of very beneficial things in your body, but its primary role is to prepare the lining of your uterus to receive and nurture an embryo and to help maintain an ongoing pregnancy. So having a good level of progesterone in your body is critical to getting pregnant. Now, the really important thing to know here is that your progesterone levels change significantly throughout your menstrual cycle. And this change is completely dependent on ovulation. So during the first part of your menstrual cycle, before you ovulate, you only have a tiny amount of progesterone in your bloodstream. But after ovulation, after you've released an egg from one of your ovaries, you start making relatively large amounts of this hormone. And this increased level of progesterone can be detected in your blood. So doing a progesterone blood test or serum progesterone can help your doctor figure out if you're ovulating or not. If your progesterone level stays low throughout your cycle, then this indicates that you haven't ovulated. But if your progesterone level increases beyond a certain threshold, then this indicates that you have ovulated. And your doctor might also use a progesterone blood test to get an idea if your progesterone levels after ovulation are high enough for successful implantation and for a successful pregnancy. Now, before I go any further, I want to make it really clear that it's imperative you get your blood drawn on the correct day of your menstrual cycle. If you get your test done on the wrong day of your cycle, the results can end up being inconclusive, or even worse, suggest that you have a problem even when you don't. So I've made another video on how to do your progesterone test the right way to make sure you get a meaningful result. And I'll link to that up here and in the description below. So what do your progesterone test results mean? Let's start off with what progesterone level you're looking for to confirm that you are ovulating. Now, unfortunately, different laboratories often have different values for this, which can make things really confusing. And this is partly because often the test isn't timed well, and the reference ranges need to take this into consideration. But if you have timed your progesterone test correctly, you can be confident that you have ovulated if your progesterone level is 3 nanograms per mil or above. And this equates to around 9.5 nanomoles per liter or above, depending on what units your particular lab uses. If your level is below 3 nanograms per mil or 9.5 nanomoles per liter, then this tells you that you probably haven't ovulated, at least not in that particular menstrual cycle. But again, if your results suggest that you haven't ovulated, do make sure that you have timed your test correctly by checking out the video I mentioned earlier. Okay, what about the level of progesterone that's needed to support implantation and allow you to get pregnant? How high does this need to be? Now, you might have heard that for successful implantation of an embryo and for pregnancy to occur, you need to have a progesterone level of at least 10 nanograms per mil or 30 nanomoles per liter. And you might have read this figure online somewhere, or you might have even heard it from your doctor. But as you know, my goal with this channel is to give you accurate science-based information. And when I looked at the scientific research on this, I wasn't convinced that this figure is actually correct. Instead, it looks like the progesterone level needed for pregnancy is probably lower than this. This value of 10 nanograms per mil or 30 nanomoles per liter seems to have come from a study of women who were given a particular kind of fertility medication called HMG, or human menopausal gonadotropin. And this HMG can have the effect of increasing progesterone levels. So for women who are not using HMG, the minimum value of progesterone that was identified in this particular study may not actually be appropriate. And another more recent study backs this up. This 2018 study was carried out in women who weren't using HMG, including some who were trying to conceive naturally. And this study concluded that the minimum amount of progesterone that's needed to get pregnant is actually only 5.6 nanograms per mil, or around 18 nanomoles per litre. But probably the higher your progesterone levels, the better. Some research suggests that progesterone levels do tend to be higher in pregnancy cycles compared to non-pregnancy cycles, and that a nice high progesterone level in the days following implantation is less likely to result in an early miscarriage. Basically though, no progesterone level can guarantee that you'll get pregnant or guarantee that you won't miscarry. But a good high level a week or more after you ovulated is a good sign. Now, having said all of that, it's really important to keep in mind that progesterone levels fluctuate a huge amount over the course of a day. In fact, they can fluctuate eightfold in just 90 minutes. So one single lowish reading does not automatically mean there's a problem. It could just be that your blood was taken at a time when your progesterone was at a low point. And if you went and got it tested a second time, there's a good chance the next result could be much higher. And finally, what does it mean if a progesterone blood test result comes back really, really high? In my experience, this can sometimes be an early sign of successful implantation and pregnancy. But it can also mean that you've released two eggs in that cycle rather than just one. This is called a multiple ovulation. And if you'd like to know more about this, I've made another video on the topic, which I'll link to up here and in the description below. So to summarize then, the progesterone blood test can be a very useful test to help you and your doctor figure out if you're ovulating or not. But it's imperative that the test is done the right way. If it is done the right way and the test is done at the correct time in your menstrual cycle, you can be confident you've ovulated if your result is above 3 nanograms per mil or about 9.5 nanomoles per litre. And if the result is at least 5.6 nanograms per mil or 18 nanomoles per litre, then this is likely to be high enough for you to get pregnant. But as always, if you're concerned about your progesterone levels or you need more clarification, your doctor is the best person to talk to. So that's it for today's video. If you found the video useful, please give it a big thumbs up, give it a like, and let me know in the comments what you found of most value or if you have any questions. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos like this one to get your fertility questions answered, make sure to subscribe. I hope that helps. Thanks for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you in another video very soon. Bye for now.